Now we will derive the formula using the method of the dimensional analysis. Let us see the question here first. Derive an expression for the time period of a simple pendulum which may be depend upon mass of the ball, length of the pendulum and acceleration due to gravity. So firstly, how we will derive the formula? So it is given in the question that the time period of a simple pendulum depend upon the mass of the ball. So we will assume that it be directly proportional. मान लेंगे कि वो डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल है. सो टाइम पीरियड ऑफ अ सिंपल पेंडुलम में डिपेंड अपॉन द मास ऑफ द बॉल एंड लेट अब ये मास के क्या पावर 1/2 स्क्वायर तो लेट इट सपोज मान लें कोई कांस्टेंट्स है ए. सेकंड टाइम पीरियड ऑफ द सिंपल पेंडुलम डिपेंड अपॉन द लेंथ एल एंड लेट इट द कांस्टेंट बी. Time period of simple pendulum depend upon the acceleration due to gravity. Let's see. A, B and C are some constants. Okay. So we will combine all these three and we will write time period depend upon the m to the power A, L to the power B and G to the power C. We will remove the constant of proportionality. So time period is equal to some constant will come k, m to the power a, l to the power b and g to the power c. Now what we will do, we will put the dimensions. So the value of the time period, dimension of time period means the time. So the dimension will be m0, l0 and only the dimensions of time will be there. The dimension of mass will be zero, the dimension of length will be zero. Time is the time taken to complete one oscillation. So time, the dimensions of time factor will be there and rest will be zero. Okay. Here the constant will be as it is. Dimensions for the mass is m. Dimensions for length will be l. And dimensions for the acceleration due to gravity. So we have already learned LD to the power minus 2 to the power C. So it is K M to the power how much? A L to the power how much? B plus C. When bases are same, power gets added up and T to the power minus 2C. Okay. So M0 L0 T to the power 1. Applying principle of homogeneity. Principle of homogeneity. What does the principle of homogeneity says? Homogeneity says that if left hand side is equal to right hand side, then their powers are equated. So equating the powers of m. So the dimensions of power of a. So a will become 0. L. B plus C will become 0. So can we say that B is equal to minus C? Now minus 2C equating the powers of the D. So minus 2C is equal to 1. So C is equal to how much? Minus half. If C is equal to minus half, then from the above equation B is equal to plus half. So we get, we got A is equal to 0, C is equal to minus half, B is equal to plus half. So what we will do, we will put here, this will be our first equation, we will put in first. So time period is equal to K mass, M is how much? M to the power 0, L to the power B, so the value of B is 1/2 and the value of C is minus half. So time period is equal to k, m to the power 0 means it does not depend upon the mass. Okay, so can we write like this, l upon g to the power 1/2. So we got the formula, time period is equal to k under root l upon g, where k is the constant. We have learned that we cannot derive the value of the constants by using the method of dimension. In this way you have to derive the formula by the method of dimension. Once again, I will repeat how you have to approach towards the problem. First, you will read the question carefully. What are the things given? Dependence, that which quantity is depending upon the which quantity. So it will not be given that this quantity depend upon the square or cube, but simply in the question it will be given that the time period depends upon the mass. So we will assume the constant A, B and C. Okay, we will put all together. We will, by removing the constant of proportionality, we will put the constant, something constant K, and after that we will write the dimensions. By using the principle of homogeneity, we will equate their powers, mass, both the are equal, length we will equate, time we will equate. We will get certain equations, we will solve those equations A, B and C. We will find the values of A, B, C and we will put in the equation 1, we will get the answer. Okay, thank you.